makers. This is Kevin Osborne from baldwisdom.com, and today we're going to make a filament dryer to breathe new life into old filaments and make it possible to use some hard to use filaments like nylon and polycarbonate. And I'm really excited to be printing in some new filaments, nylon and polycarbonate. And also I've been discovering some of my filaments have been around a little too long and the desiccant bags in them have worn out and they start to degrade in performance. And one thing I've been reading a lot about on the internet is that when the filament absorbs water, it doesn't particularly hurt the filament, but eventually when you try to print it, the high heats there cause a chemical reaction to happen that causes the water to combine with the plastic, and you get really crappy prints. This is especially true for nylon. I'm going to be doing a separate video on printing with nylon and polycarbonate, but for now I'm going to concentrate on trying to solve this problem. I had an old spool of nylon, and I knew for sure that I'd need to dry it. And so I put it in my convection oven pretty much overnight, and it did work pretty well, although there was still some steam coming out of the nozzle. And so I'm probably going to write that spool off, but I got some new nylon and it printed very well out of the bag, and I want to keep it that way. So I decided that I would get a filament drying solution in place. There's two parts to this. One part, which we'll cover in this video, is building a filament drying solution, where I'm going to use a food dehydrator to do that. And then the second part is, while printing, you want to keep it in a dry box. That's a box that has desiccant in it that absorbs water out of the air and feeds the filament dry into the printer. You can also store the filament in these boxes, or you can also just store it in a plastic bag with desiccant. It's a common myth that you can just stick a filament that has absorbed water into a bag with some desiccant and the desiccant will suck the water out of it. It really doesn't do that. The desiccant mostly removes the water from the air. So the desiccant's not going to actually actively pull the water from the filament. So you can buy a dedicated filament dryer for about $100. I'll put a link down below in the description. But I chose to go another way. I chose to go with the DIY because that's how I roll. And also, I think that some of the food dehydrators have a little more control than the ones you can buy. So the disadvantage is that the filament dryers, you can actually print directly from them. You can actually spool the filament out from them. But I don't really have enough room to set that up anyway, so I'm gonna be building a dedicated filament dryer box. So I bought this food dehydrator on Amazon. It's a little more expensive. You can get them down to about 15 bucks if you buy them from Alibaba, China. I went for more. This is around 70 bucks. I got it because it has a digital control, which allows you to control both the temperature. You can use higher temperatures for the high temperature filaments and lower temperatures for things like PLA. And you can also set a timer so you don't have to watch it so much. You don't have to be there right when you want to take it out. So that's why I got this. And it has these stacking trays, and they flip over each other so that basically the whole thing, this tall stack, which is much thicker than this box, will hold two spools of filament. And then they reverse back down and stack so they'll fit in this box. So I'll have a handy way to store it as well. Okay, so because trays like this, and some of them have handles and some of them don't, and you flip over each other to stack. But what's the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna clip around here, and we're gonna remove the center section. And I've already done that for one of them here. And so you'll see like this. And this allows us to create sort of a hollow chamber. Don't forget to leave one of them for the bottom for the filament to sit on. If you don't do that, you'll be sitting right on the bottom of the food dehydrator, and it's not level. And that might cause some other problems with airflow and things like that. The other thing I'd recommend you do, which I didn't do, but I lucked out, is because you're voiding the warranty here, so make sure it works before you start tearing it apart.
and we're done. So here we are. You can see it's got a nice hollow space in the middle. Some people actually even print 3D print spool turntables in here, so you could do that, and you could actually then add feeders to the side if you want to. And then we can stack two rolls of filament in here. That's TPU 90 from Ultimaker, and this is Ninja Flex. Two filaments that definitely benefit from drying. And then you can also add in your desiccant bags that need drying out, because these will refresh in here. Do remember though that, you know, the more stuff you put in there to dry out, it's more water that has to be removed, so you probably should run it a little longer.
So that was pretty easy. I set it for 10 hours at 130 degrees for the flexible filament. If you're going to do it for PLA, you're going to want to set that a lot lower, maybe as low as the thing will go, probably around 80 degrees or lower. The PLA has a low glass transition temperature, and it'll get all squishy on you, and it'll deform, it'll get all wiggly, and that's, especially if you've got a Bowden tube, that doesn't work out so well for you. So if you have any more experience with filtering, I'd love to hear from you. Leave a comment below. If you get something out of this video, give it a like. And please subscribe to my channel. We're going to be doing more, not just 3D printing, but other maker things. We're going to be building Nerf shooters and doing some electronics and doing all kinds of fun, makery, nerdy stuff. So I'll see you next time.